Hey guys, what's up? It's Christine Seal, the High Level Queen, and in this video, I'm going to show you guys how to set up hosted videos without using a third-party platform. And yes, you can put them in funnels, you can set them up inside of a gated area, and you can change the controls as you wish. So let's get started. Okay, step one, we're going to add the video element to your funnel. So I want you to go and open your funnel and go ahead and edit it. And then we're going to go to elements, add element. And we're going to look for video. So we're just going to drag that where we want it. And then we're going to go into our video settings over here on the left. And then we're going to go to hosted video. And we're going to click on select video. And then we're going to upload a video. And let's upload this video here. So we're going to wait for this video to upload and come right back. Okay, now we've uploaded our raw video and we're going to go ahead and click on it to initiate the encoding process. All right, so we've gone ahead and done that. Now I'm going to talk to you a little bit about the playback controls. So I need to move my face. So down here on the bottom left, you're going to have some playback controls. And I'm going to tell you what each one of these things does. So autoplay here, you can toggle this on for your video to play automatically when the page loads. Now, caveat, as of the timing of this video, the video is actually going to start playing muted, just FYI, okay? Okay, so that's actually according to autoplay regulations on iOS, Safari, Chrome, Android, Firefox, and Edge. So unfortunately, they have to start muted, okay? You can also allow player pause, which means that you can turn off the controls if you want. So if you don't want them to be able to pause the video, you would turn this on, okay? Allow playback speed control. This is going to let them speed up your video or slow down your video if they want to do that. And then show pending time. This is actually what's going to show your viewers how much time left of the video is remaining. So you're going to have that little progress bar at the bottom. And then you can also allow full screen toggle or not with this here. And you can show the progress bar if you're not using a tracking video, which is going to let them fast forward and rewind your video. Okay. Now this last one is really cool because you can actually gate your visitors and make them opt in order to view the video first. Okay. Now I'm not really going to talk about if you should or shouldn't do that. I'm just going to show you how to do it. So if they land on your link and they haven't yet filled out their name and email on your opt-in form, you can redirect them to a form to opt in before they are allowed to view your video. If you want to do that, you can go ahead and turn this on. However, you're going to need a page to redirect them to if they haven't already done this yet. So you're going to actually set up an opt-in form here. I don't have that in this funnel, so I'm just going to go ahead and turn that off. Okay. So now what we should be able to do is to see our hosted video. So I'm going to go ahead and preview. And then after this loads, I'm going to show you how, cool, that actually worked. I'm going to show you how to set up a workflow. So this is my hosted video. You can see all the controls. You can see it started auto playing, but there's no volume, which is pretty standard for Vimeo. This is a Vimeo video here and it's auto playing as well, but there is no sound. So you'll notice with the third party hosted videos, there's no sound when the video loads. Okay. That's just part of the regulations. So I've got this ready to go. And now I'm going to show you guys how to set up a workflow and tie everything together. Okay, so now if you want to set up a workflow, you're going to go into automation, workflows, and then create a new workflow from scratch. And your trigger is going to be video tracking, because I told you guys that there's video tracking now available. And what we're going to do is we're going to add a filter based on the video that you just uploaded, right? So when that video is this, right, then we're going to take some actions. Now, I skipped over this important part here. You can actually select the funnel. You can select the specific video, or you can select the video duration, right? So if you only want to do this if they watch less than 50%, you would do one thing. If you want to do it if they watch more than 50%, you would take another action. This is where you would do that, video duration. And then you can say it's greater than 50%. Then you would take a specific action. But in this video, I'm going to show you how to do it if the video is the one I just uploaded. If they watch it at all, okay, if they watch it at all, then here we can take unlimited actions. It's really cool. We can send them an email, we can send them a text, we can send them a voicemail drop, we can send them an Instagram DM if they've messaged your page, all kinds of crazy stuff. But I'm gonna just do internal notification, and then I'm gonna say notification, and then I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna say contact, full name, watched the video, right? And then this is going to go to me and save it. And save it. Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and save it and turn it on and go back over here, open up my funnel, and go ahead and play my video. Just make sure that it's good to go. And then I'm gonna go back over and look at the history of my workflow. And if you want to make sure that this is actually going to work, what you have to do is you have to put the video behind an opt-in page in order for this to actually work correctly. So I'm guessing you're probably gonna do that anyway, since you're using it for maybe a webinar, VSL, or any kind of sales funnel. You're gonna want them to opt in anyway. So after you set up your opt-in page, then you should be able to use this workflow. So I would put this in front of the video and then play the video on the next page, if that makes sense. So I hope this helps you guys to set up video tracking inside of an all-in-one platform that is going to replace all the things that you used to use before, and there's no need for any third-party software. Don't forget to like and subscribe so you don't miss any future videos from me, and I'll see you next time. If you love my videos, but you find that you still need help with your automation systems or high level in general, I have great news for you. Nerd Level Academy is your one-stop shop for all of your training needs on high level, whether it's learning high level, setting up automations, automating your agency and your client onboarding, or even an SOP library. So go check it out at the link below, and I'll see you on the inside.